So Python is also a object oriented programming language. So we should have to learn about class and object. So what is a class? Class is a template. And what is object? Object is an instance of class. So class contains data types and member functions. It will group the data types and functions. And as a group, we are storing it as a class. And class is just a template. Always remember that class is just a template. So we will be defining functions inside the class and data types inside the class. But to access these functions or methods, we should have to create an object. Object is an instance of class. So we will be creating the object and then we will be accessing those functions inside the class using the object. So in the real-time example, let us consider suppose there is a builder who is building 100 apartments. So first what he will do, he will create a template like what is the size of the one apartment and how many doors should apartment have, where should be the kitchen located, where should be the bathroom located, where should be bedroom located. So once the template is finished, he will start creating the objects. Objects are nothing but the real apartments. Object is the instance of class and object uses the member functions of the class. To access the functions inside the class, you should have to always create an object and access it. You will be clearly understanding when once we go into the example program. So class contains data and functions inside it. It is a group of data and functions. We can create n number of functions and group inside a class. So this is a class name. Let us say we have created a class vehicle and model color registration. Let us say these three are of data types and forward, backward, stop. Vehicle can go forward, can go backward, can stop. So these are the functions. So we are grouping all this and giving it a class name and we are creating an object. Let us say object is a car. We are creating a car using this class. And car has a model, color, registration number, and it can go forward, backward, stop. So we can create any number of object. So let us say we want to create one more object, which is bus. Bus is also a vehicle. So we can create an object bus with reference to this class. And all these functions and data types will also be available to the bus. So like this, we can create n number of objects using class. Class contains functions and data types and it is just a template. That's it, you should have to remember. So like this, object is an instance of a class. This is a class and we can create objects here. Like it contains name, attributes, behavior. All the attributes, behavior, all are inherited to the objects. And we can modify as per our requirement inside the object. So like this, data to access the function inside the class, we should have to create an object. Object 1, object 2, object 3. We can have n number of objects. So this is like an example. We have created a class called car. Now we are creating objects. Like objects are, we are creating a hatchback, sedan, convertible, van. All this belongs to the car class, but they have their different specifications. So this will be understanding a little bit more once we go into the example program, and in the next video we will be seeing how to declare a class, what is the class syntax. Meet you in the next video.